Hello, very good morning. Today we will discuss ideally integrated development environment and script mode. Ideally script mode and variables. So what is ideally? Ideally stands for integrated development environment, and as literally it means it is integrated. It provides an integrated development environment. Here it means we write a program, and when we run, we can see the output in the same cell, same windows. That's the meaning of integrated development environment. As we all can see, we give the command, for example, to give the command like any expression like 10 plus 20, 15 plus 5, etc. And as we press enter key, the output is displayed in the same window. But in the next, in the script mode, we will see that the output is displayed at once after writing the program. So this is ideally, and the next is script mode. In interactive mode, basically when we use expressions, it works similar to a calculator. And interactive mode is used to write small programs, and its one disadvantage is that the output is compressed or embedded or displayed between the statements. We write the statement, that is command, press enter key, we get output. Again we write the command, press enter key, and get the output back. But in script mode, we use script mode for lengthy programs. Interactive mode is not suitable for lengthy programs. So to write lengthy programs, we use script mode. And to use script mode, first open the Python cell window by following start all programs, Python, and whatever its extension is, version is. And then after opening the Python cell window, we will follow the steps, click on file and select new option. A new file will be displayed. Then write the program, and after writing the program, we will save the file with .py extension. .py is the extension of Python file. And then after saving the file, we can run the file by using function file F5 key, or following the steps, click on the run menu and select run module. And in script mode, we can save file, and the advantage of saving a file is that we can use this file later time. So as when we save a file, then it can be run in next time as many as time we can run that file again and again whenever we will need it. Now variables. In Python or various computer programming language, while we write program, we may use to store some values in the storage. And when we need, then we need to fetch or retrieve or bring the value from the storage for use. So similarly, in Python, it is also required to store some value in the storage. Variable just does this work. However, we all have studied variables in maths, in algebra. There is similar meaning of variable in both, whether it is maths or in computer programming language. In both, as in maths, we take x equal to 5. It is given that x equal to 5 and y equal to 7, and find the expression like this. Find the value of the given expression. What we use? we just put the value of x and y respectively, what has been given, and then solve it. Similarly, it is done in the computer programming language, but here the meaning of variable is somehow something different from the maths, and that is, as we need to store value in the storage, in the memory storage of the computer. So suppose this is the memory storage of the computer, and we need to store a value, say 10. So we must define a variable. Suppose we give a equal to 10 as it has been there. When we do so, computer reserve a space and give that space, that location name A, and store the value what has been assigned here, 10. Say 10. And whenever we would not need, we will just use variable name, not 10. We will use variable name, and we can bring the value of the variable that it consists. So here the definition of variable, that variable is the named memory location that is used to hold some values. The values may be constant, that is any number, or in further later class we will study, the value may be a string value too, that is alphabets, name of any person or something else. Again, variable is the named memory location that is used to store some values, or in other words, variable is the name of the location of the memory that holds some value for further use. So here let us have an example. A equal to 10, here variable is A that holds the value 10, and B equal to 20, B is a variable that holds value 20, and C is another variable that stores the product of A and B. Here A multiplied by B, this is the asterisk. We use this operator for multiplication in computer programming language. So don't get confused, this is asterisk that we call star. It is used in computer programming language for multiplication operator. And here, whatever the value of A multiplied by B will be stored in memory location C. And now we can print the value of the product, whatever it is, using print function. Print the product of 10 and 20 is, comma C. Here, it must be noted that your statement, whatever the message we want to be displayed on the screen, has been encoded by single inverted comma. This is the structure. You must follow this. And after the statement, there is comma, and then the variable which value we want to display on the screen, want to be displayed on the screen by the computer. And as we run, the value will be displayed. Now, where we give a name to a variable, we must keep something in our mind. That is, there is a fixed rule to write a variable name. These are the first. A variable name must start with alphabet or underscore. That is, whenever we will declare a variable, we will use a variable, it must be start with any alphabet, whether it is small in capital case or underscore. And the next, a variable name consists of alphabets, digits, or underscore. That is, other than these alphabets, digits, and underscore, we can't use any other special characters like percent, dollar, asterisk in variable name. But here limitation is that we can't start a variable with digits. We can start a variable name by alphabets or underscore. Here one thing is to keep in our mind. We can use digits in the variable name, like someone. This is a valid variable name, but not one sum, because here it is being started with one, that is digits. So this is wrong variable name, and this is someone, this is right, or some underscore one, whatever it is. And the next is, a Python keyword cannot be used as a variable name. Here keyword means, suppose print function. So print is a command, so we can't use print as a variable name. And other keywords, like we will study further data types. In data types, int, int stands for integer, float, 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 float is used for the number having decimal point. So these are the keywords. A keyword means here these words have some specific meaning to the computer. This is the keyword means it has some specific meaning to the computer. So keywords cannot be used as a variable name. And a space is not allowed in a variable name. Suppose someone, and as we use someone, this is the valid variable name and this is invalid variable name. Here there is a space given between some and the digit 1. So it is not a valid variable name. And the things to remember, two things to remember, a variable name can be of any length, means whatever we want, 5 alphabets or 10 alphabets or 15 alphabets, it can be of any length. But we don't need a variable that has 50 alphabets including digits and underscore. A variable name should be simple, so as it can be used in the program easily. There is no need to give a lengthy name to a variable. Variable name is given always simple, that is comprehensive to us. And next, variable name are case sensitive. Here case sensitive means, suppose there is a variable say sum. Here the sum case is alphabet, this has been written in a small case. Say I declare other, this has been written in capital case. So these both will be treated differently, because in Python variable name is case sensitive. So small case and capital case will be treated differently, and so on. The next topics are data types in Python, type function and input function. Let us discuss this. What is a data type? While working in Python, while we write a program in Python, we may have to work with different types of data. Say, we may need to use an integer, whole numbers, say 5 or 50. Or sometimes we may need to use a decimal value, say 3.5, 15.5. Sometimes we may also need to use the name of the person, place or thing, that is any name. Here we see that I discussed three types of data, three different types of data. One, simple integers. The second, the number having decimal point, that is decimal value. And the third, the name, that is a string. So these types of data, these are the different types of data, and we need here at the right moment, we need to specify these types of data, because this data requires different size of memory to be stored. As int requires less memory space, float would require the space more than the int, and same is the case with string value, that is collection of alphabets. So it is a good practice when we define data types, then computer stores as much storage it requires according to the data type. So we can define data type as, data type is the type of data that a variable holds, type of data of the value that is stored in an identifier or variable. Here identifier is the same as variable, again type of data value that is stored in an identifier or variable is called its data types. In Python, there are three types of data, say int, float and string. Further, int has been categorized in three: plain integers. Here we may say that int stands for integers, but remember that int is a keyword. We can't modify it if we have the sense as its data types. Further, int has been categorized in three: plain integers, and plain integers ranges from 2,14,74,00,000. And please refer the book to see its range. 2 negative, there is negative sign, minus 2,14,74,00,000, and the next digits are also used in the number. Please refer to the book. 2 positive, this is positive, 2,14,74,00,000, and so on. And the next is long integers. We can use the integers having greater beyond this, and if the integers beyond this, it will come under long integers. Here one thing is to be noticed that when we use plain integers, it requires less space, and when as the size of number increases, the more memory storage is required. And the third is bool. Bool stands for boolean. It is logical values in the form of true and false. And in computer programming language, 0 means false and 1 means true. I have already discussed in the previous class. True and false, a logical values in the form of true and false is called boolean value. We will see its examples later. The next is float. Float, as int represents integers, and float represents decimal value. Say, we will have the examples the next. We will discuss it. And third is string. A string, a sequence of characters. That is, our name is a string. Name of the person is a string. Name of the place is a string. So, this string consists the characters, collection of characters quoted by single inverted comma or double inverted comma. We must encode a string value by single inverted comma or double inverted comma. Let us see the example. Here the example of int is 1500 minus 1986. This is the int data types, example of int data types. Float 709, 789, 17.234. Python, here don't get confused that how 709 is a float value. It can be Python underscore language is a string data type. Here you can see that as string data must be enclosed by a single or double inverted comma. So here see, the Python underscore language has been quoted by single inverted comma. This is string data type. In 124 less than 987, it is the boolean value. Then it yields if the condition is true, then its output is true, otherwise false. In this condition, its output will be true, as 124 is less than 987. It checks, it compares it, and print the value true or false accordingly. If the condition is true, it will print true. If the condition is false, it will print false. The next is type function. As literally means, type function is used to know the data types. That is, which type of data we use. Say, we want to know that which type of data is 100. So write the code. This is the Python prompt. We just type type 100, and as we press, when we will run, as we press enter key or when we will run this, it will display class int. That is, 100 is int data type. The next, we want to know that which type of data is Kumar. As it is a string, so must quote it with, enclose it with single inverted comma. It will print class string. Suppose we want to know which type of data is 17.5. Class float. In the next, we take a Boolean expression type 5 less than 10. Which type of data it is? Class bool. So, if whether you want to know the which type of data types a given data is, we can know by using type function. And the next is input function. It is very interesting function, input. As in the previously, we have seen that a equal to 10, b equal to 20, and c equal to a into 20. When here we have three variables, in the first variable a, the value has been assigned 10, b has been assigned 20. Here one thing is to be noticed that equality is called assignment operator. In computer programming language, equality is also an operator. As plus, minus are operators. Similarly, equal to is also an operator, and it is assignment operator. Means equal to sign is used to assign a value to the variable. As equal to symbol is used to assign a value to the variable, that's why it is called assignment operator. But when we write a program and using such variables, it has some limitations. Means once we assign value to the variable, its value cannot be changed. If you want to change the value, you must open the program and edit the program. Say if you want to change the value 10 to 50, then we will open the program and edit the program. 15 b equal to something else, 25. So it is not user friendly. So to remove its limitations, to overcome its limitations, input function is used. Input function is used to assign the value to the variable during runtime. Means when we will run the program, the message will be displayed on the screen and it will ask the user to enter the value. Suppose a equal to input, enter first number. B equal to input, enter second number. C equal to A plus B, print the sum is C. Let us see how does this work. I have written the program instead of this, or as here it is multiplication, I change it. And we will write the program and save the program and run the program. When we will run the program, the message will be displayed on the screen. It will prompt the message to the user. That is, user is who will run the program. Enter first number. The user must enter the number, some value, say 10, and press enter key. Then the next message will be prompted on the screen. Enter second number. Enter second number. Say input 20. And as we press enter key, after entering the second value, the result will be displayed as the sum is 200. This is how input function works. Just make the difference and fill the difference between assignment, statement and input function. And again, we can again run the program and then provide some different value, whatever we want. Again, the next time we will use 50, we will use 70, whatever we want. So make the difference between assignment, statement and input function. This is how input function works. Here we can also display the name of user. We can also display our name. Say, to display your name on the screen, A equal to input, write your name. Print A. One thing is to remember, in input function we also use variable. Say A equal to input, write your name. Now we run the program. Press F5 key. As we press F5 key, the message write your name will be displayed on the screen. Write your name. And here say we write John, whatever John Cummins, and as we press enter key, the here name will be displayed. Again, here A is a variable that holds the value whatever we will provide during runtime. So the difference between assignment statement and input function, both have the same objective, same functions, both stores value, but input function as a variable assignment statement is used to provide the value while writing, we write the program, during writing the program. But input function is used to assign the value during runtime, means when we run the program, it asks the user to enter some values and gives back the result accordingly. Thank you.